students here are experimenters to determine angle of minimum deviation for a given prism by plotting a graph between angle of incidence and angle of deviation. As we know, we see in the figure, we have ABC is a prism, and we see AB and AC are the two refracting surfaces, and PQ is an incident ray, and we can say RS is what, the emergent ray. We can see an angle is formed by the extended incident ray and the extended what, emergent ray. This angle is called angle of deviation. We see also that we'll be studying with our experiment setup that how this angle of I with different angles at 35, 40, 45, 50, 55 and 60, this range we take these different angles and we'll study how this angle of deviation varies with this angle of incidence. And later we'll plot a graph between angle of deviation and angle of incidence. And from the graph, we will find the value of angle of minimum deviation. Yeah, students, here, as you see here, we have taken a board. On this, we have fixed a white paper. And what you've done, you can see here, we've drawn a horizontal line here. And mark 3 points, O, X, Y, at the points at a distance around 5 to 6 centimeters from each other. Then first, what you do, draw a normal ON1, draw the normal XN2, draw the normal YN3, okay? Now what you do is there, then what you do is mark some angle of incidence from the normal, mark it this here, let me here I've taken as what, 35 degrees on this ray, and then what you do, draw a line which is called an incident ray. On this incident ray you place two pins here, if you can see one pin here and the other pin on this incident ray, okay? Then what you do is take the prism, trace is what, outline of the prism, okay? The one refracting surface facing this incident ray, the other refracting surface here which is facing me, okay? Take the third pin here, you can see this pin here, we take this third pin in such a way that we see the images of these two pins which are on the incident ray and the third pin, so that all the three lie in what, in the same straight line, okay? After doing this, fix it at a point where you see the images of these two pins and that this third pin which we see that all the three are what, in a same straight line. Then you take the fourth pin in such a way that the images of these two pins, the third pin and the fourth, lie in what, in a same straight line. So we fix the third pin and the fourth pin in such a way that these two pins and the images of these two pins, they all four lie in a same straight line. After this, what you do is remove the prism, encircle these points where we placed what, the four pins, mark this ray as incident ray, okay? Now what is it, extend this ray, incident ray, and this ray which we formed is what, emergent ray, extend this emergent ray, this angle is called angle of what, deviation. Then take a protractor, measure this angle of what, deviation. We see this angle of deviation is what, 38 degrees. So students here, as we see that for angle of incidence of 40 degrees, we get the angle of deviation as what, 30 degrees. Similarly, we can measure for different angles of incidence, that is 45, we can measure angle of deviation here. As we can see here, ON1 is there, measure an angle of what 45. And then measure what is, you get the angle of deviation. So you'll take 6 different observations ranging from 35 to 60 on the sheet, 3 on one side, the other 3 on the other side of the sheet. So 6 observations are taken. Now you plot the graph between angle of incidence and angle of deviation which you got from these sheets. When you plot the graph, you'll get this type of graph. On this graph, we see that the angle of deviation, what is it? It's decreasing as angle I is increasing. Can you see here? And later it becomes what? Minimum. And later, and after that, as angle I increases, angle of deviation also increases. This value at which angle of incidence when angle of deviation becomes minimum is called, what is it called? Angle of minimum deviation. So from the graph, we'll find what, when does the angle of deviation becomes minimum, which you have to find. Thank you.